Hey, it's Jessica, and welcome to another episode of Austin and Ollie. So unless you've been living under a rock, you are probably aware that concrete vessels are a very up-and-coming trend. So today I'm going to show you exactly how I make concrete vessels and use them as candle holders, as well as flower pots when your candle is burnt out. And not only that, I'm going to show you exactly how I make candles in them and how I add a little witchy flair and make them intention candles. So here we go. These are the molds I use. One is hexagon shaped, one is cylindrical. I will link them in the bio. And this is the cement I use. It is quick setting cement from Quikrete. I just got it at my local hardware store. Always make sure that you're safe and use gloves as well as a respirator when making this project. And you want to make sure you're using cement and not concrete. Concrete has way too many aggregates to be used in such fine molds. So you're going to take a cup and measure out just a little bit of cement. This is the easiest way that I found to do it. So for this, you really want your water cement ratio to be 4 parts cement to 1 part water. And I found that it's easiest to put a tiny bit of cement in your cup and then put a bit more water than you would actually need in your cup. This really helps you to get all of the cement out of the bottom of the cup when you stir it. Otherwise, it can be tricky to get everything off of the bottom of the cup. And we just keep stirring. You really want to stir this really well. And then you're going to sprinkle cement on top of the mixture until you get the consistency that you want. And I think this is really the easiest way to make sure that everything is stirred well and you get the exact consistency that you're looking for. You're really looking for kind of a pancake mix consistency. And here you can see this is pretty perfect. And then you're going to pour this on top of your mold. And the next part is key. You want to tap the mold onto the countertop or the ground or whatever surface you're working on, and tap the sides as well. This helps release any air bubbles that are held within the cement. Otherwise, you're gonna have pockets in your vessel when you're done. And I like to do a couple of small batches of cement at a time and pour them over just so that way I'm not wasting any. And I did run out of cement, so this is a bit too liquidy, but it ended up actually working out well. And now we just tap the sides and make sure we really get all of those air bubbles out. And here we are unmolding. It is pretty tricky to get this out of the mold, but it's also very satisfying at the same time. I let my concrete vessels dry for about 12 to 24 hours. I have seen people use plaster of Paris to quicken the drying time, but I've also read that they can make them more fragile and more prone to cracks. So I prefer to just wait. And here's the vessel. And it turned out pretty perfectly. No bubbles. And now we work on sealing it. So I'm using this sealer that I just got at my local hardware store, as well as polycrylic and just a clear coat. The two on the left you're going to use for the inside, and the clear coat you're going to use on the outside of the vessel. So I did find that spraying this is a bit tricky. I kind of wish I just got the polycrylic that you paint on. But I'm not going to waste it. So
So I spray it on and then I wipe out the excess with a paper towel and then spray on another really light coat just to make sure that everything is covered in the polycrylic, but there aren't any pooling in the bottom. And then we're going to continue with all of the rest of our molds. So I wanted to show you this one. This one is what happens when you don't tap your mold enough and get enough of those air pockets out. There are quite a few inconsistencies on this, but I think it adds character, so I'm still going to use it for myself. And once the polycrylic has dried, then I go in with this sealer. It's a cement sealer. I don't know if it really makes a difference. I've never tried it without this and only using the polycrylic, but it works, so I'm not going to change the process. So I do kind of the same thing where I just spray it in and then wipe out the excess and then do another really light coat just to make sure everything is fully covered but that it's not pooling anywhere. And we're going to repeat the process on all of our molds. So once that has dried, then we're going to add the clear coat to the outer portion of all of the vessels. And make sure you use this in a well-ventilated area, and you're also using a mask or a respirator. And you just put a light coat on everywhere and make sure everything is sealed nicely. And then set it down upside down so that everything has a chance to dry. And repeat this process for all of them. So now that our vessels are made and they are sealed, it's time to start making candles. So I find the best way to measure out exactly how much wax you need per candle is by putting in the amount of water up to where you would like the wax to be. And you do have to remember that you're going to add in fragrance oil, so I make it just a little bit more shallow. So this is about where I want the wax to come up to in my candle. And then I'm going to take my scale and my cup and zero that out. And then I'm going to pour the water into my cup. And so whatever is measured on the scale is going to be the measurement of the liquid less the measurement of the cup. So you get only the weight of the wax that you need to put in the candle. So I need about 8 ounces of wax in order to fill this candle up. And then I'm going to take my soy wax and just measure out 8 ounces. And always remember to zero out your scale with the cup on it. Otherwise, you're going to be adding the weight of the cup to the weight of the wax, which you don't want to do. And once I have 8 ounces, then I'm going to make a double boiler and heat this up. So I heat my wax up, or I make my double boiler at about, I'm not sure what temperature it is, but I always go to about 2.5 on my stovetop. And then we just put that in and that'll cook. And while that is heating up, I'm going to measure out my fragrance oil. So I am using this blackberry vanilla scent from Brambleberry. I absolutely love their fragrances. I'll put them in the description. I like to use 7% fragrance oil per candle. I think it makes them really noticeably scented, but it doesn't go overkill either. So I measure out 7%, and then I'm also going to mix my mica, or the colorant of your candle, in with the fragrance. And then, so once the wax is melted, then I can add both of those in together. And the mica, I do this just so it dissolves into the fragrance oil prior to mixing it into the candle wax. So once that's all dissolved, I set that aside. And I'm also going to get my wick ready. So I use these glue dots that I got, I think it was just at Michael's, and these pre-soaked wood wicks. I got them off of Etsy. I'll link that in the description as well, but they are absolutely beautiful. They are pre-soaked in soy wax, and they are crackling wood wicks, which I think just adds a really nice touch. And they also come with these little candlestick holders, which is great. And then I just take the glue dot, put that at the bottom of my wick holder. And then I'm going to set that into the vessel. You want to make sure it's centered as much as possible in the bottom of the vessel. And push down just so that when the heated soy wax is added, it doesn't go anywhere. So as you can see, there was a little bit of mica coloring left in the bottom of my double boiler, but I'm using a bluish purple color on this one, so I really didn't care too much to empty it out. But once your wax is completely melted, then you can turn off your stove and remove your double boiler, and you can add your fragrance and colorant. So I give it another quick stir, make sure everything is distributed properly, and add that in, and then stir everything together. So with some containers, when you are making candles, you want to heat them up so that way the wax doesn't break them. So for instance, with glass, you would want to heat the vessel up a little bit prior to putting the wax in, but I'm not doing this with my concrete vessels. So once you pour the wax in, then you want to wait and just make sure that it's drying before you put anything else in. So this is the witchy part of the candle. I am adding in some herbs that I have muddled together. I muddled together some lavender and rose, and I think it's just, it adds a really calming, uplifting feeling. And I'm also going to add in a feather. I got these off of Etsy. They are chicken and rooster feathers, and they represent the wind element, which I think is just a really nice touch. And the same thing with these seashells. I also got these off of Etsy, and they represent the water element. And I think it's just a really nice touch. So now the candle displays all four elements between the concrete or earth, the candle actually being lit, fire, the feather for air, and the seashell for water. And then I'm adding in a clear quartz crystal just to add some vibrational qualities and enhance the other crystals that I am going to put in here. And for this candle, I'm adding in a moon pendant just because I think it's pretty, as well as this goblet pendant. And then last but not least, I am going to add in our crystals. So for this one, I'm doing rose quartz, amethyst, and a black onyx. Just so this candle has really calming and uplifting properties. And then I am going to cut the wick down. I cut mine to about a quarter inch length from the wax to the top of the wick. And there you go. I absolutely love this candle. I think it's going to be a great gift. And last but not least, I also made my own seed paper. And I'm going to tie that onto the vessel. So that way, when the candle has burnt out and all of the wax is gone, you can simply put some planter soil in the bottom, put the tag into the vessel, get it a bit damp, and then you can grow your own flowers in the same pot. And there we go. Hope you guys enjoyed. Let me know how your candle making experience goes and what you guys come up with. I'm excited.